Hello and welcome. This is Randy with Excel for Freelancers, and today we have a great training. We're going to show you how to copy rows down, insert rows above, and delete a selected row all from a single click in a table in Excel. So stay tuned, it's going to be a great training. Alrighty, let's go ahead and get started. Before we go into the what and how we do this, let's go over the why. Why would we want to create the ability for a user to delete a row, insert a row above, or copy down when they could pretty much do it very simply with right click of an option? Well, actually, there are several reasons, and let's go over them. One is it's faster. If you're going to be deleting a lot of rows or copying a lot of rows, it can be done on a single click very quickly. So that's one reason if you've got a lot of it to do. Another reason is security. You may want to protect the sheet so that a user can only delete certain rows or certain rows based on a specific condition or insert rows based on a specific condition. Having this type of work through VBA allows us to check for certain conditions. So that might be very helpful in VBA if we do it through VBA. Another reason is tracking. If a row is deleted, if we do it through VBA like it is here, we have the ability to track what was deleted. You could potentially write some code that before anything gets deleted, the contents of the row get copied over to maybe a hidden table, and as well as the user who deleted it, so that you have a track record of who deleted what and when. So that can be very helpful. Even though offhand it looks pretty simple, it could be extremely powerful if you use this type of feature. All right, so now let's go ahead and get into the what and how we are able to achieve this. All righty, so into the VBA module we go. We can click on the developer tab here and go to Visual Basic. If you do not have the developer tab or you don't see it, you can get to it. Simply go into the file area and go into options. When you see the customized ribbon, we'll go ahead and click developer, and that will get us viewing the developers tab. So into the Visual Basic we go, and let's go ahead and go over it. And basically what we see here is on the sheet one, we have a target, which is E4 to N100 on selection change. And that means that if we select any particular cell between E4 and N100, then the following code is going to run. And what is that code? Well, the first of which is B2 is our target row. And we use that for conditional formatting. And to get to that conditional formatting, that is going to help us. That's going to put the target row in B2. And I'll go ahead and show you that, although we've gone over that in detail. And if we slide over here to the left, we see 9, B2. That is our selected row. We've left that there. And all we've done is basically gone into the conditional formatting. And I've just added a single rule to, let's go ahead and pull that up. Well, we've got a few of them here, so let's go ahead and remove those from duplicating. Okay, so now we can see B2 equals row. Okay, and let's go ahead and make sure we've got just that range selected, so we can highlight that and just select that. Okay, so B2 equals row, and that is for the entire range, and we formatted that. You can format that any way you want to. As soon as that row changes, so does the format. Okay, and that gives us the ability to add those conditional formatting and highlight the selected row. Next up in the VBA, we have our ability to display the buttons, a macro. This is a macro that will display the buttons. And then we also have hide the buttons, and we have that beyond the else. So that means anytime we select E4 through N100, we want those buttons to display. Else, meaning if we select outside of those, we're going to hide the buttons. And that gives us the ability so that if we select a cell outside, they're going to be gone. If we select inside, they're going to show up. And that's nice. We only want this feature when we select items within our specific table. Otherwise, we don't want to have those options available to us. I'll go ahead and hide these columns. We won't be using them. And so that is helpful for when we want to hide that. Now let's go into the individual macros that I have created, and we'll go ahead and go over those. So that is pretty much it for the on-sheet code. It's very simple, very, very simple. And I've put all the macros in our module. I've created a module, and we've gone over how to create modules, but simply right-click, insert the module, and then change the name of the module under properties, okay, and select the module and change that name. Make sure you give each module a name. When you have a lot of modules, you'll want to know how to change those names, okay? So that's all I've done. Now when we click on row macros, we see our display buttons, okay, our display buttons macros. And what we're going to do is we're going to go over each one. What we've done is with active sheet, the reason we've said active sheet, not sheet one, this gives you the ability to copy and paste this code into pretty much any sheet. If you were going to copy and paste this into sheet two, you'd have to change it to sheet two. And pretty much we'll only be working on any active sheet. So in this case, active sheet will be just fine. And I've gone ahead and named each of these buttons. I've given them specific names. If you click on the X, you see I've given that delete row button. And if you click on the insert row above, I've given that a name. And likewise for the copy down, okay, I've given that a name as well. So you can see that back into the VBA. And all I'm saying is on active sheet with the shaped delete row button, what do I want to do? Well, first I want to make it visible, okay? Second, I want to put it to the left of D and the active cell row. So the active cell row is whatever row we've selected, right? And then we don't want to offset it any rows or any columns, so we've left that zero, okay? We do want to move it slightly, and we've done the same thing for the top. We pretty much said, okay, we want it to show in column D. This is the starting position, column D, okay? But because we want to move it over a little bit, remember, the delete row, we want to move it over to the left a little bit, okay? Because we need to make space for all three buttons. So we're going to increment that minus negative, meaning it's going to move to the left, minus 31. And we've repeated the same thing for the insert above, except the only difference is this one's minus 15. That means it's going to be moved a little bit less over to the left, okay, as you can see. And also for the copy down button, this one is no increment. So that one's going to be right on the edge of column D, okay? And that spaces out our buttons accordingly. And that's pretty much it for the display buttons macros. Okay, next up we have the hide buttons macro, and that's simply three lines of code where we're taking the active sheet and those shapes, and then we're making them visible and then making them false. Okay, the visible property of each button is false, so that's very, very simple code. Okay, and next up we're going to get to this move buttons in a minute, and I'll show you why. Let's go over the deleted row, okay, the deleted row code. And basically this is the macro when we click back on our sheet and we click a cell. When I click on the X button, the delete button, and right click, and we assign the macro, and I've assigned the macro the delete button, the delete row button. Okay, so I've assigned that macro there, okay? And I've done the same thing for the other two shapes as well. I've basically assigned delete row, insert row, and copy down. I've assigned these three macros to the three individual buttons, okay? On the delete row, what I've done is I've defined the selected row. In this case, it's a little bit save space. You could just use active cell row, and you could just replace this, but I've decided. And I've used selected row for all three. So what I've done is I've dimensioned that all the way at the top here, right? When you use this before any macros, it can be used for all of them. Okay, so it's nice. It just saves some space. So also to save some space, I've used selected row. And basically what I've done is, what will happen is if this knot's here, if we delete a row, if example, if I delete this row right here, all those buttons are going to get deleted too. We don't want that, okay? If I copy down a row, all the entire buttons are also going to get copied, right? Because you know in Excel, when we delete something, everything in that row, including all the shapes, get deleted. Well, we don't want that, right? We don't want to copy them. We don't want to make copies of the buttons, and we don't want to delete them. We want them to stay just where we are. Well, in Excel, Excel will copy everything. It'll delete everything. So what we want to do is we want to just move those buttons up a row temporarily, just move them up, right? So that we can delete the row without deleting the buttons. And so what I've done there in the code. So to move them up, right? All I've done is here is an active sheet, right? This for this specific button top. I want to move it, right? Up the active cell minus row, which is up, minus one row is up. So I've moved each of these buttons just up one row, okay? So I've moved them up, and that way, when this row gets deleted, the buttons won't be deleted. So that's kind of an important step. And so the next line of code is simply active sheet range, select row, and entire row delete, okay? And then the next line of code is I want to select whatever the new row is. So when we delete a row, right, and we click delete, I want the next row to be automatically selected, and I want those buttons to be displayed again. Okay, so here in ActiveSheet, we've selected it, and then we're going to go ahead and display the buttons again with that macro. Okay, and that's just going to run once we select a row, we can display them. So we just run that macro one more time. The insert row above is also very simple. We take the selected row, we define that as the active cell row, and then we just go ahead and we take this row and we insert the entire row up. It's just one line of code. And then what we want to do is I want to select that row above, right? I want to select that row. So when I insert above, I want to select the row above. Okay, insert above, select the row. You could pretty much do select the existing row. You can do what you want here. It just gives us the ability to move around and see what works best for us. Okay, and then we can also, now when we copy down, what we're going to do is we're going to once again get the selected row. And second, we're going to hide the buttons. And then we're going to move the buttons up, right? Remember, we want to move them. Because when we copy down, it's going to create duplicate button sets if we don't move them up a row, okay? But copy down allows us to copy down, and we still have just one button set, okay? And we can keep repeating this over and over again. It's a very quick way to copy, so I really use this in a lot of my applications. It's a great way to do it, and it's also a great way to delete, right? It's actually quite quick. So it's one of the features that I love. That is pretty much it of all the macros. It's quite simple, quite easy to use. Once we copy the row, or we copy it down, and then the application cut copy mode false, basically that just turns off the little, what they call them, dancing ants, right? When we copy, right? Right, we get those little, we call them dancing ants around that border, and it just, the cut copy mode false just takes that off, okay? So that's the reason for that. That's why we do this. And then we want to display the buttons again, okay? So that's pretty much it for this. It's a very simple lesson, but it's actually quite a powerful tool. I definitely, please want you to pick up a copy of this workbook and use it yourself, and I'd love to see your creations. So please get yourself a copy. There's a link above where you can download it, and it's free, of course. So I'm happy to share it with you, happy to teach you. And if you can, please like this video, and please share it in your favorite group. I would be forever appreciative of that. Thanks so much for joining me today.